Good morning children. So we are discussing multiplications. Now today two properties in the multiplication we are going to discuss. One is about the distributive property and one more one breaking the multiplier. How to do this multiplication using these properties, that we'll discuss. Okay, so everyone open your maths class four books and write the heading multiplication using distributive property. Multiplication using distributive property. Multiplication using distributive property. So here first sum, write the first one, multiply multiply 45 by 15 by 15 using distributive property. Okay, first one, how to do this one? So first what you have to do means 45 into 15, isn't it? So write 45 into 15. Here what you have to do means, first you change that, what is the property here? It means a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b. Okay, plus a plus c. A into b plus a into c. This is the rule. What is that means? First we have to divide the given number. Divide the given number. A into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. This is the rule. So how to do this one? How to implement to our sum? So a is equal to 45 into that 15 is there, no? 15 we have to divide like 10 plus 5. 10 plus 5. So write 10 plus 5. Over next, what you have to do means, after separating, then a into b plus a into c is there. It means 45 into 10 plus 45 into 5 with the separate numbers. Do the multiplication. 45 into 10, 415 plus 45 into 5, 5 5s are 25, 2 is remainder, 5 4s are 20, 20 plus 2 is equal to 22. Okay, now do the addition, you will be getting 5, 7, 6, 675. This will be comes under the distributive property. So the with the multiplier has to divide into two parts, two different parts, and with that we have to multiply the multiplicand. Then last we have to do the addition, then we'll get the product of that number. Okay, based on that, page number 58. Open page number 58, children. In page number 58, we are having the first Roman 125. Roman number 1, this multiplying, one more sum you can do, children. Multiplying 125 by 15. Or you can write it multiply 470 into 132. 470 into 132. Same. First you write it. 470 into 132. First, what you have to do? 470 as usual. This will be comes under how much? 100 plus 32. Okay. Now, 470 into 100 plus 470 into 32. Here it will be 470. After again, two zeros will be continued. Now, 470 into 32. Do the multiplication. 2 into 0, 0. 2 7s are 14. 1 is the remainder. 2 4s are 8 plus 1 is 9. So, 1's place completed now, 0. 3 into 0, 0. 3 7s are 21. 2 is the remainder. 3, 2, 4s are 12. 12 plus 2 is equal to 14. 0, 4, 0, 1, 5 and left. So, 1, 5, 0 plus 1, 5, 0, 4, 0. 15,040. Now, do the addition of 47,000 plus 15,040. 47,000. If you do the addition, you will be get it 62,040.
Remaining sums, page number 58, section 1, first one, 1 B, A, B, D. These three sums you have to do, children, using the distributive property. Okay. Next, after completing this, you can write one more heading. Breaking of multiplier. Same, that also will be comes under this model. Second method, breaking the multiplier, breaking the multiplier into, breaking the multiplier into factors. Okay, first one. It is having the factor of 6 5s are 30, isn't it? 6 5s are 30, these two are the factors, 10 3s are 30, that is also factor. So, the factors of 30 is equal to 5 will become 6 also, 10 also. So, combination of these two will take it. How to do the sum? 378 into 30. 378 into 30 can be divided, 6 5s are 30. Okay, we made 30 into factor. Now, 378 into 6 plus 378 into 5. Do the multiplication, 6 8s are 48, 4 is the remainder, 6 7s are 42 plus 4 is 46, 4 is the remainder. 6 3s are 18 plus 4 is equal to 22 plus 6 8 5s are 40, 4 is remainder, 5 7s are 35 plus 4 is equal to 39, 3 is the remainder, 3 5s are 15, 15 plus 3 is equal to 18. Now do the addition of 2268 plus 1890. If you do the addition, you will be getting 8 plus 0 8. 6 plus 9 is equal to 15, 1 is the remainder. 8 plus 2 is equal to 10 plus 1 is 11, 1 is the remainder. 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. So answer is 4158.
Like this, you have to divide the multiplier into factors. Okay, next. Second sum, pair number 58, it is having 1735 into 200 is there, that you can be multiply like 20 into 10 and 400, that also 20 into 20 and 150, that you can be write like 5 into 30 or 30 into 5. So like that you have to break the multiplier into factors. Next, Roman number 3, find the product of textbook page number 58 only, children. Now Roman number 3. Find the product of first one, 3700, and first one is very easy one only, so you can do it. I'm doing the B1. 13501 into 4511. So using the regular method only, how to do the sum, children? Same, 13501 into 4511. Our regular method only, from the ones place have to do the division. 1 ones are 1, 1 zeros are 0, 1 fives are 5, 1 threes are 3, 1 ones are 1. Ones place completed, put 0 in the ones place. Now tens place, and you have to start the answer also from the tens place itself. 1 ones are 1, 1 zeros are 0, 1 fives are 5, 1 threes are 3, 1 ones are 1. Put 2 zeros, because 1's place and 10's place both we completed. Now 100's place, 5 ones are 5, 5 zeros are 0, 5 fives are 25, 2 is remainder. 5 threes are 15 plus 2 is equal to 17, 1 is remainder. 5 ones are 5 plus 1 is 6. So 3 digits we completed. Put 3 zeros. 1, 2, 3. Now 4 ones are 4. 4 zeros are 0. 4 fives are 20. 2 is remainder. 4 threes are 12 plus 2 is equal to 14. 1 is remainder. 4 ones are 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. So now add the following. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. 1 plus, like that. All the zeros only now, so answer will be 1. Here also zeros are there, only 1 is there, so directly can write 1. Next, 5 plus 5, 10. So 0 in the 100's place and 1 in the next column. 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, 4 plus 5 is equal to 9, 9 plus 4 is equal to 13, 1 is the remainder. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. 0 here and 0 in the next column. 7, 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. 6 plus 4 is equal to 10, 1 is the remainder. 1 plus 5 is equal to 6. So this is the answer. Like that, all the sums, remaining sums, you have to do it as a homework. That is related to the section 3. Now coming to the section 4. Read, think and solve. Here in a form there are 387 trees in a row and there are 45 rows. How many trees are there in the form? So the first statement, what you have to write, children? Number of trees in a form, number of trees in a form is equal to 387. Next, number of trees in a row is equal to 45. Now multiply 378 into 45, then you will be getting last statement. Therefore the number of trees are there in the form is equal to the total, the product, what you'll get it, that you have to write. Second one, in a school there are 1879 students. If each of them pays rupees fees 235 per month, how much money does the school earn in a month? So this also, number of students is equal to 1879. Second statement is the amount paid by each student per day, per month, is equal to the fees per month is equal to, fees per month is equal to rupees 235. Now multiply these two, you'll be get the total amount, how much they'll paid in that 1 month. Third one, the weight of one load of bricks is 2358 kgs. What is the weight of 215 loads of bricks? So first one, the weight of loads of bricks is equal to 2358. Second one, the weight of load bricks, each load brick is equal to 215. Multiply these two, you'll be get the total product. Okay, so like that, today's homework, complete page number 58, Roman number 1 to 4. In each section you are having 3 or 4 sums, children. So do it neatly and perfectly. Before doing this, once revise all the tables also perfectly. Okay, and next day we'll discuss about the divisions.